Hello, our viewers, welcome to Ask Dr Ssekiwunga. This is your channel where you learn medicine. You just need to subscribe to our channel for you to learn more about your health. You can always ask a question through our Facebook channel, Instagram, Twitter. Ask any question of your choice, you'll be right away answered. We have a friend, he's called Davis. Davis asked that he has a grandmother at home, but she sleeps with chicken, with her chicken in the house. Would it be having any health effects on the grandmother? So to answer this question, I have a friend, I have a guest by the name Dr. Ssekiwunga Rodgers. He is a chicken doctor, but we are going to be interacting on this and we'll find out whether it is really safe for you to sleep with chicken. Dr. Ssekiwunga, how are you?
I'm okay.
You're welcome.
So, of late, we have a lot of issues when it comes to sterility. So some people are preferring to transfer their animals from where they keep them to their own houses.
Yes.
That's for safety reasons. Others breed for love of their lives. Others breed because they don't have any other way out of how they can keep their animals. But another thing.
But I remember for us in the villages, you could find a chicken are sleeping in some corner and then we also sleep in some corner. So
yeah, in most cases, resources are the ones we are making us that way. But not that we ever wanted to make like that.
But this is not something we want.
Yeah,
first
yeah.
of all, it lowers your sleep quality. You know when these birds or chicken they are making a lot of noise, you know, you cannot sleep well. They're not good. And actually some people go on and sleep with their dogs, their pets. I don't know how really some people take it.
Actually, if I can go a bit back to the chicken, it's also not good for the birds themselves. Because they are standards of a quality poultry house. A chicken house is different from the human house. I've been to very many places where by someone calls it a human house for birds. More expensive, but does not meet the standard.
Yes.
In most cases,
so there are those standards someone has to meet.
Yes.
Just give me like two.
What? A chicken house must be having perfect ventilation.
Yeah.
The solid walls are not supposed to be there.
Okay.
The wall must be very short, down 3 feet. The rest must be mesh. But we have few individuals who sleep in mesh.
Yes.
That's one. Because chicken environment of oxygen, ventilation must be very key.
And you find that the humans are competing with the pets for oxygen.
Yes.
And well, this, I think, can be very detrimental to their lives.
Yeah, very. So it's not very good. Mm-hmm. And then another problem with that is the diseases.
Yeah.
Chicken, all other animals, have diseases we share with
so
them.
So you mean humans can infect chicken and
yes.
other pets?
Yes.
Some people keep dogs, they keep cats. I don't know if chicken can also be kept as pet.
Yeah, they do. There are some people who do it as pets, but not so, so common in Uganda.
Yeah.
But other countries I've been to, they do chicken as a pet.
Okay.
Yeah.
So any diseases we can transmit to the chicken or pets?
Yeah. For example, there is a speech we can share. One of them is salmonella. You humans transmit to the animals. Sometimes you think that it's only animals which are transmitting disease to you. But we also do a lot.
So like
of
you can transmit HIV to birds or
it may not be HIV per se, but there are other diseases which can be transmitted from you to the chicken or other animals. And one of them which is very common is salmonella.
Also humans suffer from salmonella, actually it's what people call typhoid, and actually one of the transmitters, some people get typhoid from birds, from pets, from so on.
Yes.
So I think it's not good to sleep with this.
Yeah, it's not good
pets.
At all. So you also have other diseases which will be from human to animals. Things like fleas,
yes.
like mice.
Okay.
You find you have your dog without fleas. But if you fleas to the house with fleas, you end up being infected.
Can,
so,
like chickens can humans
exactly.
spread
they do. Humans spread chickens too.
Yeah, because actually when you look at also these the dogs, the cats can also cause rabies to humans.
Exactly.
Can cause like cats can cause this disease called toxoplasma gondii. Toxoplasmosis is a very dangerous disease and you find that it's spread from droppings of these cats. So I don't know, our friend should really advise the grandmother not to sleep with these bats.
One of another diseases is called rabies. Many people think.
You mean we can.
Rabies, yes. Many people think that rabies can only affect dogs. Then the dog will bite the human being to get rabies.
Yes.
But rabies can be spread in any other way. It can be even through saliva, any contact from an infected, either human or a dog, can cause rabies. So even if a human is having rabies, his saliva or drinking water and deposit the germs there, and the dog tastes that water, the dog can end up with that, with the rabies. So it is too well.
Our viewers should know that really sleeping with these bags or beds at home is not a good habit. It causes a lot of diseases, like we mentioned, a lot of other diseases. Disease causing diarrhea, like giardia, like combined factor, they will cause a lot of bad effects, health effects to humans. However,
maybe before you come to another issue we can speak about is also sometimes when you sleep, for example, chicken at home, there is that contact it evokes with your children.
Okay.
I've never been to a home whereby the kid is so much connected to a cock that when it was slaughtered, the kid was depressed, actually involved serious problems because the friend had been killed. So sometimes it can reach that.
So they take them as real, real friends.
Yeah, a friend. So sometimes you can reach that level. So we can, if you can avoid, we can do that. We can avoid.
So, but there are some people whom you cannot separate from their bags. You cannot separate them from their cats, from their pets. What advice can you give them to stay with them, but still develop some healthy behavior there?
That is very, very important because some people are just animal lovers. You cannot separate them from animals and bats. So what you can do if you choose to do with your bats or your cats or dogs, you have to make sure there is limited problems and are crossing over from you to the animals and from the animals to your side. One of them, you have to make sure you follow good vaccination routines. For example, make sure your dogs, cats are vaccinated against rabies, against all other diseases that affect you. So that you can reduce the disease and you can make it to humans. Number two, you have to maintain high level of hygiene. This is for humans and animals. For humans, do proper fecal disposal. Most people don't dispose pieces very well. You have kids in the house, but they are literally in pieces everywhere. And you have an animal is going to come, sometimes it's going to eat something, transmission of worms, so all that will happen. So disposal is very key when it comes to cases like that. Then you have, if you have dogs, you have to groom. Grooming, you have to wash, use shampoo. Yeah, also another thing, you have to make sure you isolate the sleeping place for the animals from the sleeping place of humans.
So don't you can sleep in the same house. You can be, the beddings should be different.
You can be in the same house with them and move around with them, but at least the bedroom must be different. There must be a place where they can be.
And again, our viewers should know that really these diseases may even affect those people who are the elderly, the children, the pregnant mothers, and people are exposed to HIV because their immunity has now gone down. So like the viewers, the grandma stays in her bags, I think it should be clear to her that these bags can cause a lot of health hazards to her since she's living entering the advanced ages. And last from this, I know there are people, some of you cannot be separated really from your pets. People like keeping their dogs, their cats as pets. At least always wash your hands after touching them. Avoid putting them in your beddings. Trim their nails like Dr. Ssekiwunga has talked about. So practice all those hygiene measures in order for you not to get the disease. Thank you very much, Dr. Ssekiwunga. Thanks for always sparing time to come and elaborate for us about concerning veterinary affairs.
Anytime, and actually, I thank you for that YouTube channel.
Thank you.
Because actually, soon, I may be definitely becoming my doctor. Because I'm learning telemedicine through your YouTube channel.
Yes,
so for people who have not yet subscribed, please go and subscribe to that YouTube channel. It's free, and there's a lot of useful information. Like me, I'm gaining a lot from it. So feel free to go and subscribe. You'll get a lot of information.
All right. Thank you very much. We can't add on more.
Ask Dr. Uthuman.